22, chances are you probably experienced a delayed flight at one point or another. And a DIA disrupted flights, topping a recent list of airports with the most disruptions.
Not a good list to be on. Let's get right to Lisa D'Souza on it live this morning. And especially, it just feels like in the last couple of months, it's gotten worse.
It seems like that is the case, certainly not just for Denver, but other airports as well. Of course, there's a whole host of reasons as to why you could experience a flight disruption, a delay or cancellation. I will say here at DIA, things are looking pretty good, just what you'd expect for early in the morning. Seeing a few Delta flights that are canceled, but again, nothing too crazy. But according to a recent study by AirHelp, it was just last month that Denver ranked at the top of the list of airports with the most flight disruptions. So disruptions, again, typically means delayed or canceled flights, according to officials with AirHelp, which is a company that helps flyers with airline claims. So the list says for January, DIA had a whopping 34.4% of its flights disrupted. You can see it here on your screen, followed up by Fort Lauderdale International, O'Hare, Orlando, and Chicago International as well. So while you may think of weather as a key reason for delays, experts say that's not always the case.
A lot of times what happens is really congestion in the air. It's you know, not having slots. It's, you know, especially in 2022, it has been the difficulty of airports and airlines to be able to staff properly to handle the, you know, the return demand to travel.
All right, so we reached out to DIA. They are not yet available for comment this morning. Of course, we'll let you know when we get an update there. But experts say staffing issues, of course, including the ongoing pilot shortage, that is just another factor in all of this that airlines really all over are grappling with. Of course, if you're concerned about the possibility of your flight getting delayed, experts say, you know, it's a good idea to know which airports are potentially some repeat offenders. You might want to consider not having your layover in one of those airports. So some good information here about DIA, something to keep in mind. Maybe also add some buffer time in between your flights as well. For now, we're live at the airport. Lisa D'Souza, Fox 31.
Do you feel stressed there at the airport, or do you feel calm?
You know, it is calm here right now, good. So, and I'm a little bit tired, so I feel pretty calm right now.
Some people get anxious just walking into the airport. Oh, I love
it. I get excited. I'm yeah. Like, let's go.
I like the airport, today. Too.
I'm yeah. With you.
Are you jealous of everyone headed out right now somewhere? Awesome.
Depends on where they're going.
I mean, everyone who's headed someplace warm, I'm pretty jealous.
Agree.
Yeah.
Agree. Sure. Thank you, Lisa.